Hi, welcome to Love and Forever Evolving, where we are always and forever evolving. Hello, Virgos. Welcome back, my loves. Welcome to your love reading. I hope all has been well, Virgos. Hope you've been taking care of yourself, eating plenty of fruit and vegetables, and taking in plenty of water, and taking care of that beautiful, sexy-ass temple of yours, Virgos, as it take care of you. Ashe, welcome back, my loves. Come on in, have a seat. We're going to see what messages source your angels, your ancestors have for you in regards to love, Virgos. Shout out to the soul tribe. Shout out to the evolving spirits. Thank you all so much for your comments, your love, and your support. I appreciate you, Soul Tribe, all right? If you would love to become an evolving spirit like I myself, don't forget to click that notification bell. Don't forget to click that join membership button that's down below. It's going to give you exclusive discounts on your personal readings, your email questions, and also your love live stream questions when I go live, my loves. I Shay, and welcome back to the ones that are new here. Thank you for your support, all right? Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell on your way out, my loves. I Shay, all right? Are you guys comfortable? Are you guys ready? You done sat down. You done got comfortable, Virgos, huh? All right? So we're first going to use the Oracle deck here to see how your person is feeling towards you. All right? We already have some cards wanting to come out there. All right, we're going to see how the energies that are surrounding you, I want to see how they feel towards you and this connection here. All right, and definitely stick around. I'm going to use the Love Romance Angel deck here for you as well. And then we'll finish up your spread here with the traditional tarot deck, I Shay, to get further clarifications for you, right? So the readings here today may resonate for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North, and South Node placements, okay? And Cross Watchers, welcome back, my loves. You are welcome here as well. All right. So let's see here. Source angels, ancestors, protect my space, aura, and my heart as I channel the messages here for the God and Goddesses source. What do we have here for the divine masculine, the divine feminine source? What messages do they need to know when it comes to the energies that are surrounding Virgos in the month of April, source? What do we have for my sexy ass Virgos? Wow. We have self-esteem here, Virgos, okay? So this particular person that is around you, their self-esteem here, they may be having issues here when it comes to their self-esteem. They may do not as much, you know, look at themselves in a higher light here, okay? They are not in a place where they're happy with themselves, okay? All right, it says, I possess gifts of the soul that benefits me and others, all right? So this person is needing to work on their self-esteem when it comes to the relationship, when it comes to the connection here. All right, what's at the bottom of the deck? Yes, we have humor. I choose to focus on the lighter side of life. That's like I said, this person is not viewing themselves in the light, okay? This person is not, you know, allowing things to, you know, go naturally with the universe here, okay? There could be very uptight, very controlling here, not having a sense of humor here, all right? Taking things serious as in that are not necessarily needed to be taken serious when it comes to trying to control the situation or control the relationship here. And source is guiding them to have a sense of humor when it comes to their love life, when it comes to their relationship here. Let's see what we have. Yeah, because we have doubt here. Okay, so this person is doubting themselves as well here. All right, we have I release the need to know all the answers. Yes, like I said, this person could be very controlling or was trying to be very controlling when it comes to you, Virgos, in the relationship here. And they doubted themselves because they may feel like they didn't have control like they desired to have here. All right, and they definitely didn't come from a heart space because we have the color green here being standing out here in both cards here. So there's definitely a person that wasn't coming from their heart space when it comes to their relationship. There was definitely lack of love here when it comes to their relationship as well here, I feel. And then, yeah, we have indecision here. I use my intuition to all aspects of life. So this tells me that this person do not and did not use their intuition, okay? They shut their intuition out. Basically, they shut their higher selves off and was making decisions from their lower self a lot. There was definitely a pattern here when it came between this person here and how they make decisions when it comes to this relationship, because they had a lack of self-esteem as well, all right? They have lack of self-esteem issues that they need to work on here, Virgos, okay? And this is why they had a lot of doubt, not only in themselves, but when it comes to this relationship, okay? Wow. Let's move forward here. Let's finally now use the Love Romance Angel deck here. Let's see what is the foundation of this relationship or this connection that you have had here, Virgos, with this person here. Some of y'all may find yourself removing yourself from this person's energy here in the month of April. Or some of you all have already removed yourself, Virgos, from this particular energy here that is surrounding you. Okay, this could be a significant other, a spouse here. This could be a family member or someone that you have engaged your energies here with. Okay, yeah, we have engagement here. Your love life is extending to a higher level of commitment here, Virgos. Okay, so there is someone that you are going to be engaging yourself with here. Okay, all right. Wow, let's see what else through source. What else in regards to this connection here, source? What else do Virgos need to know in regards to their love life here for the month of April? What else, source? What else do we have for earth signs here, source, for the Virgos? Thank you. Yes, I just said this. Look at that. Let go of control issues. I'm not making this up. I know what the fuck my aura tells me, okay? Because I follow my intuition over here, honey. Strong, all right? And it never leads me astray. Allow this situation to unfold naturally. And I just said that as well. I said this person doesn't go naturally with the divine's flow, all right? They don't follow their intuition. They probably haven't even heard of intuition or even know what the fuck an intuition is, okay? Because they're too busy trying to control the situation. I said that this person was very controlling here, okay? And because they felt like, again here, that they couldn't control the situation here, they start doubting themselves. They start having very low self-esteem for themselves. And when that happens, this person start doing things that they know they don't have no fucking business doing. Hurting you. Being disrespectful. All right, hurting your feelings, causing pain when it comes to this relationship. Because again, if they feel like they don't have control over you, ain't that a bitch? If they feel like they don't have control over you, Virgos, all right, then they go bananas. They go crazy. All right, get the fuck out of here. We don't have time for that shit. All right, so this is a situation, like I said, that you all had to remove yourself from, okay? Some of y'all, this is a person from your past. This could be an ex here as well. And this is why you have moved on and now you are evolving. Now you are extending to a higher level of commitment with someone else. Okay? I'm just saying. All right? And yes, last card here we have here is pay attention to the red flags. Yes, I'm not making this up. The signs are cautioning you. So not only what I'm saying here is the truth, okay, but your guardian angels and your ancestors informing you the same thing, Virgos, okay? They want you to be spiritually aware. They want you to pay attention to the red flag. So this person is probably going to try to do some fuckery shit here, all right, or try to come up with some type of scheme or fucking scandal, okay, because they obviously don't have shit else to do here, okay, when it comes to, you know, trying to control a situation or trying to control you. I really feel like because this person, it's kind of funny to me, but I really feel like because this person, Virgo, don't have access to you no more, or they don't have control over you, you're not one of their fucking puppets. Get the fuck out of here. They feel like they can't have you, all right? So they want to try to find a way to control you. Literally, this person thinks up and be like, how can I control Virgo today? What can I do to make their hell, their life a living hell? Literally, this is what the fuck I'm getting. This kind of sounds like a narcissistic person here that you're dealing with here. I ain't gonna lie. Because who the fuck gets up in their right mind every fucking day to find schemes and scams to come towards you to control you because they mad because they can't have you no more? Ain't that a bitch? All right. And it's funny. Okay. And obviously, I know how Virgos work. Y'all are fucking this person up in the head right now. Okay. All right. And that's little part. Do they know? It's why they in this fucked up ass energy. They can't fuck with a Virgo. All right. Now, come on now. Be more logical when it comes to this fucking situation here. Because obviously, we know your heart wasn't in the shit from the fucking beginning. Right, Virgos? Okay. Look, I ain't making this up. Past life relationship here. You have known each other before. Yes, this is a particular energy here that this could have been a cycle here for a lesson for you to learn. Okay. This person definitely was a karmic. Okay. And there was a lesson here between you two that you both had to learn. And this person is obviously in the energies or refusing to take in and learn the valuable lesson for themselves. Just as much as I feel like you've already learned, Virgo. You learn your lesson when it comes to this particular person. If anything, this person has taught you your worth, your self-love, all right, who you are and how you are valuable, all right, because of the decision that this fuckery, fucked up ass energy has done here towards you in this relationship. And they know that is why they coming up with fucking schemes every day. You are the, look, you are the meat and potatoes of their life. You are every day they wake up to thinking about you. It's sad, but it's sick at the same time. And because who tries to take you, you cannot control nobody in their fucking energy. I don't give a fuck. You are not meant to come here on this earth and think you can control people's energies. Who the fuck thinks that? And who the fuck think that they finna be your motherfucking puppet on a fucking string? What? They mad now because you're no longer a puppet on their fucking string no more? That you done cut yourself off that bitch yourself? And they're mad because they can't use you as a source of income, as a source to do and do their fucking dirty work and listen to their motherfucking asses? Are they mad? Yes, I think so. Yes, I think so, Virgos. Isn't that just so sad? Okay. Pray for them. Okay. All right. Let's move forward. Let's see how they're feeling here. Let's see what words they want to say out their mouths. Damn. Yeah. Look at the shit. They're very fucking toxic. All right. Just being near you is intoxicating. I bet the fuck it is, because you feeling all that nasty ass, low vibration, toxic ass energy of yours. And every time they come around you, they get sick to their fucking stomach because they can't control your ass anymore. This is like that devil energy here I'm picking up. Some of y'all, this person may be a Capricorn. All right. Or they could have Capricorn placements in their chart. Or they're just a fucking demon overall. Okay. I'm just saying, I'm going to keep it a buck 50. I'm not finna sugarcoat shit that I'm feeling, because it's not what the fuck I see with my eyes. It's what the fuck I'm feeling in my aura. Real shit. Let's get one more card here for this nasty ass energy. Boy, I bet they nasty, stinking, and disgusting. All right. What else swords do we have for this nasty ass energy here? I know I messed up everything. Well, we got that part already. We are already aware of that, you stinky, nasty motherfucker. We are already aware of that. Ugh. It's just their energy just makes me feel disgusting. Like, it almost to the point where it fucking smells. Ew. It's time for me to heal. You fucking right it is. Take your nasty ass a bow first. Let's start there. I feel like because they may have a lot of nasty energies on them just because of their thoughts and the shit that they've been doing, it's starting to feel like a fucking fungus. Ugh. I can't stop thinking about you. Well, we fucking know that shit. Okay, we can feel it and damn near smell it from a mile away here. Ugh. All right, move forward. Yes, definitely make sure to pay attention to the red fucking flags here. I'm getting disgusted over this reading here. I'm going to move forward here. Source, angels, ancestors, and no offense to you, Virgos. I'm sure you are already aware of this nasty-ass energy. But, you know, because I'm very empathic and I can feel and smell and see a lot of shit, I have to limit my energy and my space when it comes to allowing nasty, stinky motherfuckers like this in my energy and my aura. Okay. All right. I'm definitely going to take me a fucking shower after this shit. All right. Source, angels, ancestors. What do we have for Virgo placements when it comes to this scum? Okay. What do we have for Virgo placements when it comes to this scum, nasty ass energy here, source? What do they need to know? What actions does this self-esteem, low vibrational, bottom feeder motherfucker at the bottom of the barrel energy feels towards towards Virgo here? I heard Scorpio as well. Some of y'all, this person may be a Scorpio. I have Scorpio placements in their chart. source, angels, ancestors, what do we have for Virgo in this particular energy here? What the fuck do they want? What do they want? Yes, look at here. The High Priestess. Some of y'all, this person could be a Pisces here. All right, this is Pisces energy here. Okay, but this person here, they know what the fuck they're doing. They're very intuitive as well. They know exactly what they're doing. And when this card turned to the side here, that definitely tells me they know what the fuck they're doing. Okay, and it's a challenge for them because they know that they can't control you anymore. Isn't that a bitch? When cards come out sideways for us readers, this tells us that this is a challenge for this particular energy here or this person because they can't control you like they know they have been doing. That is fucking crazy. That's sick. Like I fucking said, how the fuck did y'all come across this nasty ass energy here? Ugh. Okay, there was definitely a learning lesson here. This is definitely a stepping stone for you. I'm going to say that, boy, this person has definitely, I want to say one thing. They definitely keep you on your damn toes, don't they? Mm-hmm, the Knight of Pentacles. And now they're trying to come back here with an offer here. But I really feel like this is not your person or this nasty energy here. I feel like this is, again, the energy here that's engaging with you here. All right? That because you have extended from this particular low bottom feeder motherfucker over here, this is this energy coming in. Okay? So the good news here is that you have a new energy coming in that's going to be loyal to you. Okay, some of y'all, this person may be a fellow earth sign like yourself. They could be a Taurus. They could also be a Capricorn here or a Virgo. Or anyone can embody the energies here because I did also hear Scorpio as well. Or again, your person could be a Scorpio or from the past here. But however, this is a particular person who's coming to you with the Pentacles. They not on no bullshit. This ain't no Knight of Cups or no Knight of Wands coming out here. This is a whole pentacle, honey. Okay, so they're wanting to build, okay? They're wanting to start an establishment with you and build from the bottom up, all right? Because the more you two are, you know, engaging your energies here with each other, the bond is deepening between you two, okay? And in the midst of all that, this is why your angels and your ancestors is wanting you to pay attention to the red flags, because this low bottom feeder motherfucker over here, they're trying to do any scheme or scam to try to infect your life here because they asses can't control you anymore. Okay, so be aware of that. What else, source? What other actions? Let's now focus on this new energy. Damn this energy here, okay? What else is going on in regards to this future energy here that's coming towards Virgos? What actions do they plan on taking? Thank you. Yeah, they mad. Got my cards flying all over. Don't be mad, bitch. Be glad like a motherfucking trash bag and put your ass in that bitch because that's where the fuck you belong, okay? Sounds like your trash is trying to come back, but it needs to be taken the fuck out. All right, we have the Magician here. Yes, honey, this person is manifesting you, and this other energy gonna be mad as shit. They're probably already is obviously mad. For some of y'all, have already may have found out about this particular energy here that you're engaging your energy with here. Okay, but baby, you done got your motherfucking crown back. You got all the resources and the elements here. You know how to motherfucking manifest, and you ain't wasting no time. Okay, and your ass done moved forward. Well, congratulations. Good job. Shout out to you, Virgos. Okay, you keep up the good work. All right, and get as far away from this low bottom feeder motherfucker here. All right, last card here, source. What else? What actions is this new energy taking towards Virgos in the future here, source? What actions in the future is this energy taking? Yes, baby. Okay, this person's going to be well established as well here, okay? This person's definitely going to be able to meet your needs here financially, physically here, okay? This person is going to be able to definitely meet you in the middle here, all right, with the Ten of Pentacles here, very successful at what they do as well as you are. So you two are definitely going to make a good couple when it comes to building a foundation here together, all right? This person sees you as someone that they could definitely be with for a long time, okay? This is inheritance here with the Ten of Pentacles here, okay? Let's see how they feel as far as their emotions here. Now that we got the Hidden Truth Oracle deck for that low bottom feeder here, let's see how this new energy that's coming towards you, let's see how they feel, because I know some of you all have already met this person and you have been dating this person for some of y'all for quite some time now. It have been a couple of months here, a couple of years, okay, for some of you all, and you guys are now ready to take it to the next level here is why this person is offering you this Knight of Pentacles. Pentacles, and it could have took some time, because we know the Knight of Pentacles is the slowest knight in the deck, but they want to make sure to dot their I's and cross their T's, okay? And now this person is ready to, you know, build a family with some of you all as well here with the Ten of Pentacles there, all right? What else source do we have for Virgos in this new energy? How does this energy feel towards Virgos? How did this energy feel? Well, thank you. Wow. I will do whatever it takes, Virgos. Wow. So this person is willing to do whatever it takes to be with you. All right. Wow. We have, I want to go down on you. Wow, Virgo. In other news, all right, 18 views, years old and up, okay? This person definitely wants to go down on you. They definitely fantasize about you a lot. So not only does this person want to build a solid foundation with you, but they're very attractive to you as well. Wow, I want to go all night long. I'm not making this up, Virgos, okay? Like I said, this person is very attracted to you. What's the last card we have here? I tried not to scream out loud. Oh my goodness, Virgos, what are you doing to this person here, okay? If I could be the fly on the wall, all right? But look, they try not to scream out loud. They try not to wake up your neighbors, okay? I'm just saying, Virgos. Wow, this has completed your love reading here for the next 2 days, okay? Definitely hit that notification bell again. If you're new here, subscribe. Hit that like button, all right? So where we can check back in here another 2 days. And definitely, if you would love to book a personal reading with me, Virgo, all that information is down below in the description box, my love. You take care, Virgos. I love you. Mwah. Bye-bye.